Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning. Taken from the book Straight Ahead, written by Adley A. Este, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, 13 Ways to Deny Christ. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Matthew chapter 26, verse 35. It says, But Peter declared, Even if I have to die with you, I will never disown you. And all the other disciples said the same. Children, the story of Peter and his denial of Jesus is a story every Christian should study carefully. Peter denied his Lord at the very moment when he had a glorious opportunity to witness for Christ. Three times the opportunity came to him to bear his witness. Three times he denied his master. Three times he failed. We read the story and we blush with shame. This jittery generation, with its numerality, is rushing heedlessly headlong down the primrose path of pleasure to perdition. As Christians, we must guard ourselves lest we become so outraged by evil that we begin to hate the world. Remember, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son to redeem the world. We must seek to eliminate evil from our communities because we love our fellow men and want to save them. In all our missionary endeavor, we must present a clear, sharp witness. However, are we loyal and faithful? Do we ever deny our Lord like Peter? There are many ways to deny Christ. Here are the 13 ways. Count them. Man may deny Christ by evil speaking, by foolish talking, by words that are untruthful or unkind. They may deny him by shunning life's burdens, by the pursuit of sinful pleasure. They may deny him by conforming to the world, by uncourteous behavior, by the love of their own opinions, by justifying self, by cherishing doubt, borrowing trouble, and dwelling in darkness. In all these ways, they declare trouble and dwelling in darkness. In all these ways, they declare that Christ is not in them. The Desire of Ages, page 357. Are we shunning life's burden? It is easy to shrug your shoulders and shift the burden of responsibility to others. It's so easy to say, let mother do it, let father do it, let my brother or my sister do it. In church, do we ever say, let the pastor do it? That's what he's paid for. Are we cooperative in our school projects and school functions? children, study these 13 ways to deny Him and then avoid them. Then we will be keeping our Pathfinder pledge. Share your love for God and your hope of heaven with others. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, think about it for a moment. Without us knowing it, we have done the same thing as Peter, denying Jesus. Of the 13 things mentioned earlier, are there some things that you and all of us often do? Children, ask Jesus to help you and guide you in your every thought, word, and deed to glorify His name. Ask the Holy Spirit to help you keep away from all temptations that make you far away and even deny your God. May you use all the opportunities and responsibilities given to you to serve Him with love. So finally, children, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Children, may the Lord Jesus help you, so that all day long you will glorify Him through your thoughts, words, and deeds. May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.